Hello dear students, today we are going to discuss a new chapter, that is chapter number 10, part 1. The chapter's name is Visualizing Solid Shapes. In this part we will cover introduction part of this chapter. Now the first topic is plane shapes. What is plane shapes? Simply a shape which can draw on paper. So simply 2D shapes is the plane shapes. 2D means two dimensional. Like square, circle, triangle. These are two dimensional shapes, and these shapes are drawn only at two axes, like x and y. So this is x axis and this is y axis. So simply, for complete explanation, we can take a paper like this. This is two dimensional figure because it has length and breadth, but there are no height, so it's two dimensional figure. So simply there are two axes, x axis and y axis. Now solid shapes. What is solid shapes? A shapes, 3D shapes are solid shapes. 3D means three dimensional shapes are solid shapes, like cube. Just draw a cube. Cone. These are three dimensional shapes because it has length. This is length, breadth. So this is breadth and this will be height. So there are length, breadth, height. That means it's a three dimensional shape. And this is also, cone is also three dimensional shape. And sphere like football. Football is also three dimensional shape. It is not circle, it's a football, let's suppose. So it has three axes. X axis, Y axis and Z axis. Okay students, we can draw like X axis, Y axis and this will be Z axis. So let's take example. This is a matchbox. It has length, this will be breadth and this will be height. So it's a three dimensional figure. That means this is solid shapes. Now views of 3D shapes. This is views of 3D shapes, length, breadth and height. Now the next topic is views of 3D shapes. So how many views of 3D shapes? Simply front view, side view and top view. There are only three types of views in solid shape, that is front view, side view and top view. So let's take example. It's a 3D shape, solid shape matchbox, and here we have to find which view is front view, which is side view and which is top view. So let's suppose this is front view. So just draw front view. This is front view. And this will be side view. And this will be top view. So this is top view. So simply, these questions are given in next exercise. How can we find the views of the solid shapes. So this is the simple method to find the views of solid shapes. Now the next topic is faces, edges and vertices. So simply just draw a solid shape, like we can draw cube. So let's suppose this is a cube, or you can say this is solid shape figure, and here we have to find faces, edges and vertices. So faces means flat surfaces. So like this is a flat surface, this will be also flat surface, this is also flat surface. So faces means flat surfaces. Now edges means line segment. How many line segment are there? Just count it: 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 3 are backside. So there are 12 edges. So edges means line segment. Simply we can say line segment. Now vertices. What is vertices? Vertices means corner points, like this. This is a corner point. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 8 corner points, 1 are backside, which are invisible. So vertices means corner points. Simply these are the explanation of faces, edges and vertices. So we can understand by this live example, faces, edges, vertices. Faces means like this. This one face, two face, three face, four face, 5 face and 6 face. There are 6 faces. Edges, line segment. How many edges are there? So this is line segment 1, corners line segment 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So there are 12 edges, 12 line segment. Now how many vertices are there? Corner points. So this one is first 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 corner points. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 5, 6, 7 and 8. There are 8 corner points. 8 vertices are there. So simply we can understand by this live example, faces, edges and vertices. So here the last topic is Euler's formula. So the last topic is Euler's formula. So simply F plus V minus E equals to 2. This is Euler's formula, where F represent faces, V represent vertices and E represent edges. This equals to 2. So how the question is coming in this on the basis of this formula, let's suppose a question is given F equals to 5, so their number of faces equals to 5, E equals to 9, so edges equals to 9, number of edges equals to 9, and here we have to find V. Vertices we have to find. So simply just apply the Euler's formula, that is F plus V minus E equals to 2. So just put the value of F here, F equals to 5, so it is 5 plus V we have to find minus E equals to 9, this equals to 2. So 5 minus 9, that is minus 4. So V minus 4 equals to 2. So V equals to 2 plus 4. V equals to 6. So vertices are 6 here, and this will be the answer. Now this is the complete explanation of introduction part. Now in next part, we will discuss exercises of this chapter. Hello dear students. Now the next, that is exercise 10.1. Question number 1. For each of the given solid, the two views are given. Match for each solid the corresponding top and front views. The first one is done for you. Here the object, shape of object, figure of the object is given. We have to match the side view of the object and top view of the object. One question is done for us. So a bottle, a figure of bottle is given like this, and we have to find side view of this bottle. If we see the bottle from the side, we can see like this. Simply, this is the side view of the bottle. And what is the top view of the bottle? If we see the bottle from the top, then this is the cap of the bottle, and this will be the upper part of the bottle. So this is the top view of the bottle. Now, question number B. A weight is given, 5 kg weight is given here. A figure of weight is given, and we have to find side view of the weight. If we see from the side to this weight, then we can see 1, 2 and 3. 3 rectangular shape. So this is 1, 2 and 3. This is the side view of the weight. Simply. And what is the top view of the weight? If we see the weight from the top, then we can see 5 kg. And like this upper part we can see. So here, this is the top view of the 5 kg weight. So top face, we can see. So this is the top view of the object. Now the next question, that is, a flask is given here, and what is the side view of the flask? If we see from the side, then we can see this is the string, holding string, and this is the bottle. So here, this is the side view of the flask, and this is the holding string of the flask, this one. So this is the side view of the flask. So what is the top view of this flask? So this one is the top view of the flask. This is the top view of the flask, and this will be the holding string. We can see. Now the next one, cup and saucer. This figure is given, and if we see this figure from the side, we can see like this. This one is the side view of this cup and saucer. Now top view of this cup will be this one. This is the upper part of the cup, and this will be the holding. Now the last one is container. The shape of container is given, and we have to find the side view of the container. If we see the container from the side, we can see like this type of shape. This is the side view of the container, and this is the cap of the container. Now what is the top of the container? So this one is the top view of the container. So this one is the upper part of the container, and this is the cap of the container. So this is the complete explanation of question number 1. Now next, question number 2. For each of the given solid, the three views are given. Identify for each solid the corresponding top, front and side views. Here the figure of the object is given, and in this figure it is also states that this is top, this is front, and this is side. And we have to classify which of these are front, side, and top views. So simply, this is front view. This is front view. So this figure is given here. It is front view. So we can write as a F for front view. Now, this is side view. So this one is look like, this is the side view of the object. Now this one is top view. So this is top view. Now, B part, the figure of a matchbox is given here, and this is assigning front part, this is top, and this is side. So here, this figure is look like side view, so this is side view, so here we can write S for side view. Now, this is front part, so this is front view. So this is front view. We can write as a F. Now, this is top of the matchbox. So this is top view. So we can write top, T as a top view. Now, C part. A figure of television is given here, and this is the front of the television. This will be the side of television, and this is the top of the television. So this one is look like a front view of the television. So we can write F. So this is look like side view of the television, so we can write S, and this is the top view of the television, so this is T. Similarly, the last one, question number D, a figure of a car is given here, and this is front part, this is side part, and this is top part of the figure. So this one is front part, front view, so we can write as a F. This is side view of the car, so we can write as S, and this is the top view of the car. If we see the car from the top, it's look like this, so this is T, this is top view of the car. So this is the complete explanation of question number 2. Now the next question, that is question number 3. For each given solid, identify the top view, front view, and side view of the figure. Here the figure is given, and we have to clarify, we have to classify which of these are the top view, front view, and side view. So simply, this is front of the figure. So how many faces of the blocks are here? If we see from the front, then two faces of the block we can see, 1 and 2 from the front. And if we see from the side, we can see two faces of the block, that is 1 and 2. And if we see from the top, we can see three faces of the blocks. So 1, 2, and 3 faces. So simply, there are three faces, 1, 2, 3. That means it's a top view of the figure. So this is T for this figure, top view of the figure. So simply, if we see from the front, then there are two faces of the blocks we can see. So this is front view of the figure. Simply, if we see from the side, we can see two faces of the block. So 1, 2, there are two faces. So this is the side view of the figure. So the next question is question on B. The figure is given and there are two faces, 1, 2. So if we can see from the side, then there are two faces we can see, 1 and 2. These two faces we can see. So this is side view of the figure. So if we see from the front, we can see 1, 2, and 3 blocks. So this is 1, 2, 3 blocks. So this is the front view of the figure. So simply, from the top view, if we can see from the top, then 1, 2, 3, 4 faces of the block we can see. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4 faces, and in this sequence, same sequence are there. That means this is the top view of the figure. Now, Question number C. The figure is given. If we see from the top to this figure, that means 1 and 2, two faces we can see from the top. So this is top view of the figure. Simply, if we can see from the side, so there are 1, 2, 3 faces of the block we can see. So this is side view of the figure. So if we see from the front, then we can see 1, 2, 3, 4 faces of the block. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and there are same sequence. That means it is the front view of the figure. Simply, question number D. There a figure is given. If we see from the side, we can see 1, 2, 2 faces. So this is side view of the figure. Now, if we see from the front, we can see 1, 2, 3, 4 faces of the block in this sequence. So this is front view of the figure. Now, if we see from the top, then 1, 2, 3 faces of the block we can see in this sequence. 1, 2, 3 If we see from the top, then 1, 2, 3 three faces are look like in same sequence. So 1, 2, 3 This is top view of the figure. Now question number E. The figure is given, and if we see from the side, we can see 1, 2, 3 faces of the block. So this is 1, 2, 3 This is side view of the block, view of the figure. Now if we see from the this figure from the top, we can see 1, 2, 3 faces of the block in this sequence. So this is the top view of the figure. Now if you see from the front, you can see 1, 2, 3 faces of the block from in this sequence. So this is front view of the figure. 1, 2, 3 Now this is the complete explanation of up to question number 3. In next part, we will discuss the rest of the question of this exercise. Thank you so much, students. If you have any doubt and queries, you can comment in the comment box, or you can send the message in the class 8 group. Thank you so much, students.